Hey guys, I'm Macey McCune. I am from Boyd, Texas, and I have a very deep love and passion for the sport of volleyball. And I have traveled with SportQuest in 2016, 2017, and I was also an intern this past summer in 2018, all to the San Diego project. So when it comes to sharing your faith, it can be really intimidating sometimes, because sometimes we think we may not have the answers to their questions, or sometimes we just think we don't know enough about the Bible. Actually, there are some simple and powerful ways that we can share our faith, and we hope that by the end of your SportQuest project this summer, that you will feel so much more confident in doing it, and that way is sharing your story. One way that you can share your story is telling us a little bit about your life before you met Christ, the moment you decided to follow Him, and then what it's been like for you since you made that decision. For those of you that grew up in the church and came to faith at a young age, it may be easier for you to tell your story from the perspective of what your life is like with God versus what it would be like without God. But either way, stories are a great way to connect with people in really any culture. Okay, I'm going to give you three practical tips to use when it comes to sharing your story. And number one is keeping it under 3 minutes. Keep it short, people. You will have their attention span that long and they will not lose interest. Number two, do not use any religious language, because people that aren't used to hearing religious language, sometimes they just shut down and they just tune you out when they start to hear it. So if you don't use that, you will still have their attention and they'll be fully engaged. And number three, the most important one, is always, always, always make God the hero of your story. You're not telling your story to lift yourself up on a platform. You're telling your story to let them know what God has done in your life and the impact He's made and the power of His love. All right, you guys, I am going to give you an example. So I'm going to try to share my story in under 3 minutes with no religious language and making God the hero of my story. So here goes nothing. All right, you guys, I grew up in small town Texas, very small, tight-knit community where everyone knows everyone. So everyone already knew me as this girl that never did anything bad, that never got in trouble because she didn't do anything to deserve it. And I was known as the girl that had a really good heart and that you could come to, and she was always sweet, she was always nice. And that's just what people thought of me. And so everyone had that, when you heard Macey, that's what you associated with it. And as I got older, I'd kind of let that get to my head, and I just really started going through the motions, and I wasn't actually being that girl. I wanted to be that girl, but I really didn't see a point in it because they already thought I was that girl. So what's the point in trying? Honestly, I was basing my identity off of what they thought of me. And I remember the day that I chose to turn away from that and turn towards something else and put my identity in that. And ever since I made that decision, my life has drastically changed, and it was the best decision I ever made. And ever since I made that decision, it's been so much better, and I can honestly say that every day I become more and more of that girl that they thought I was, but for the right reasons, and I'm not just going through the motions anymore, and that I know where my identity is found. So, would you like to know what that decision was and where I find my identity now? So, hopefully hearing my story encourages you to tell your story, and definitely begin thinking about it, because you will have so many opportunities on your project this summer to share your story. So, thanks for watching, and stay tuned for more videos that'll help prepare you for your project this summer.